Good afternoon, guys. It's Garrett, and before this whole entire portfolio reviews video starts, I want to say thank you guys so much for submitting your portfolios and being a part of this. You know, it's really insane on how many people want to get their portfolio reviews, how many people stayed for the 2 hours I did this. And if you guys really enjoy these, I'm going to start doing them every single week, maybe once a week, maybe every like Wednesday or Tuesday or something like that. And of course, just thank you all for following me on Twitch. Thank you all for just coming and watching. We had consistently like 60 viewers almost a whole entire stream. So it was really insane, you know, be a part of this whole entire thing. So of course, guys, enjoy the video. And I'm sorry if this video is really long, but it's full of a bunch of nice tips. So I would just throw this on your TV before you go to bed. And just watch it while you go to sleep and learn something new about designing. So of course, guys, it's been Garrett. And I really hope you guys have a really nice day. Peace out. All right, bro. If you're in here, it won't matter. So, let's go through the first port, and my phone's gonna keep going off. If I look down, it's probably checking my phone, or if I look across, it's me checking my monitor. So Twitch won't let me my name. That's weird. But for these, usually I like to go through the whole entire port first, like at least one section at a time, because like a lot of people put like their best work first or the best work last. Like, they don't really realize it, but when you put like your best work first, by the time you get to the bottom, you're not gonna really want to go through the rest. But, you know, overall, like, everything doesn't look that bad. You just gotta worry about, like, when you have stuff like this. And, it goes for anybody. Like, here. I'll do it this way. I think you guys are a lot more enjoy this if I took them out and started plugging them into things. So, let's just say that you have, I'll make this a different color. If you have something like this and you want to overlap, like, the AVI logo onto it, you don't want to keep like the transparency right here, because it's going to be like really weird when you start putting other objects into it. And like text that goes right, let me just move this, actually I'll make it smaller. Text that goes in like that bottom right hand corner just looks like a little awkward. Like, it's just like stuff like that. Oh god, this double monitor is really pissing me off. But just like the like, stuff like this, like it's not really needed to just place there, if like you guys understand what I'm talking about, that things like don't really go well together. But like right here, just like throwing the text in the middle, like that's pretty generic. And when you do like your renders and stuff like that, and you get your AIs, just make sure the files like are really clean and that line doesn't get cut up really quickly. You did a really good job here, like getting the renders good and like the Cinema 4D work. And like with like the 2D kind of stuff, like you have like a very different style with like the electricity going around, and, like the blowing up of it. But I would just try to keep it a little toned down a little bit. It's too much blue going around. That it's coming out of nowhere, like this little highlight under the text and like stuff like that. But that's overall. For the banners, I would literally just leave like this whole entire thing out of it. Like when you, I don't really have an example to show you guys. When you guys put your whole entire thing inside your portfolio, just leave like this big block away, because like you don't want to just fill up this big space with like a bunch of like gray boxes, because it just doesn't look too well. And when you do like styles like this, of course, you want to make sure that the water is blue, or not like not so green, but like it's a different tone underwater than it is above water, just so you know it like contrasts each other a lot better. And you did a really good job here at blending everything. Like the logo, I can see perfectly fine. The text looks nice. Adding the trees could have done a little bit better job, like maybe overlapping a little bit more and creating shadows. But you know, you did a good job overall with everything else. So. And with the AVIs, I'm not really too much of a fan of putting AVIs in a portfolio, but of course they're just like the generic AVI sections and stuff like that. So that's just really it. So Slime, you're up next, brother. Everyone's talking in the chat. I keep seeing my port is really bad. Whose is that? That was Burns. Yeah, I see Andrew. Yo, Zach, just submit your stuff, because you're not going to have anything. Like, you're only going to get better from submitting something like that. And I want to link my port. Yo, Noah's going to be dropping that link around. So, and yeah, just bringing into, like, Photoshop and, like, showing you guys things like that, it would do a lot better. And everything like that. So, holy smokes, guys. 58 viewers right now. What a day. Alright, so for the second portfolio we have was a Slime Designs. And I'm just going to go through it, of course, first, and then I'm just going to grab one and talk about it. But, just, like, stuff like this, like, it's just, like, generic, obviously, YouTube banners. But, overall, when you guys are, like, submitting your, portfolios and, like, putting stuff into your work, you see these rulers right here, and, the reason why they're there is because if you take out, like, Photoshop and you drag, like, your rulers, like, that's basically what it is. So, when you're definitely adding these into your Sheesh, when you're adding this into your portfolio, I would definitely just leave out these rulers as best as you can. Just like save it as a PNG and everything like that. You know, with a text too, making sure that these are always leveled. Like I can tell that these aren't leveled within themselves and that the background isn't squished and that the quality is a lot nicer. But like something like this is very simplistic and clean. You know, you did a good job with this one. And making sure that these things blend together instead of having like a hard edge would do a lot better job rather than just kind of placing it down and stuff. But the same thing, bro, with these lines, like the rulers are just like not there. And when you're making styles like this, you need to like have things that complement each other. Like you can't put a sky background and some spider webs in the thing. You know, it doesn't really work too well together, but you did match the colors of the text well with like the purple and the green. And it's just like the same thing overall with like stuff like this. If you're making a shadow, I would just kind of try your best to maybe connect these. Like here, I'll take it into Photoshop and show you guys. You guys said you'd rather light that. So basically when you're doing stuff like this, you want to like take like a pen tool or your polygon tool and just kind of like trace it around right here so that you get like a whole entire shadow. Like it's gonna look a little awkward when I do it because I don't have that white stroke to cover it, but oops, you guys are gonna get what I say. But basically like that, like it's like a 3D text that you did by yourself, if you guys understand what I'm talking about. So as again, like, I'm not here to, like, roast you guys. I'm just here to, like, tell you guys, like, you just gotta worry about stuff like that. And, I'm gonna go through your prices, just because I want to see. And your contacts. So. Alright, Slime, that was your report. What's everyone saying in the chat right now? Can you check my portfolio? Yo, Grat, I have a huge list going on. There's 32 people, so I'm trying my best to get through these. You're welcome, Wolves, if you're talking to me. And, alright, Bear, I'll submit right down the tips you gave me. Of course, bro, if you want, you can save this video. I'll be uploading it tomorrow at 12, so you guys can see that. And man, last night on the corner was rough. What style is best for a clan channel? Abstract, 3D, or what? Depends necessarily the clan. If you're, like, talking about, like, Dare or Obey or Soar, probably more like a clean style. But if you're talking about, like, a low-key team, like, maybe, like, a sniping team or trick-shotting team, I would just keep it, like, 3D, maybe, like, a little abstract kind of stuff to kind of bring stuff together. Like, maybe, like, a high global team, I would just keep it 3D, but, like, more of a professional team, definitely 2D. So. What up, Ella Dux? I see you in the chat. And, thanks, everyone, for the follow. You know, Cosmic, Andy Simon, Oranges, Nine, Wolves, yo, thank you all. I'm gonna try to do this, like, these portfolio reviews the best I can. So, just get right into it with the go on vol. I'm gonna keep drinking my drink. Alright. You have a lot of work, and it's good. It's 100% good to have work. I'm gonna go through like two sections of these. So definitely keep it. Am I part of High Artillery? I am. I'm a YouTuber there. I don't really do anything, to be honest. I kinda just chill, but I'm in the chat and stuff like that. So, who is this? This is Go On Bolt, or, Bradley, and, I'm just gonna go through the social media first, and then maybe, like, a game case, and, you know, overall, like, back to, like, the whole styles that I was talking about, like, this would be, like, a style you want to use for, like, a clean clan, or, like, a esports team, because, it's very simplistic and very clean, but, when you guys are going into, like, stuff like this, you guys can't probably see it on my screen, but if I zoom in, you guys can see it. So, I'm gonna take these rulers off. So right here, it's very hard to see. I only noticed it because I was looking for it. There's like a very distinct white line that goes down like that. And basically it's because he didn't blur or erase the layers properly. So it's just like stuff like that you guys need to worry about. But like styles like this is something you want to keep in here. And always even out the sides. If you want to leave something on the right hand side, I just make sure it's on the left hand side too. Just so like it complements each other and it's just not so based to one side. So, let's go through your football kind of stuff. So, you look like you could do more of an advertisement kind of style. As a crazy truck just passed my house. But, like, styles like this is really clean, keeping the background simple and everything like that, you know. It's better to keep everything simple and clean than it is anything like that. I'm not too sure what this is. 100 pictures of Cleveland. Maybe that was a, like a college assignment. But, like this kind of stuff, like, you gotta worry about, like, this is actually, like, really good. You gotta worry about, like, keeping the style clean, keeping the style flowing, and not have, like, such, like, crazy things going on. Like, you're doing a really good job, like, making stuff pop, but, like, maybe toning down the blur a little bit and making it glow. Like, taking this style and fixing it up with this one would have done a lot better of a job, but you know what I mean. And, like, same thing with this. It's just, like, the same stuff over and over again, like the monogram initials. It's just, like, keeping the same blocks the same width would do a really big help and job into you doing your stuff. So, that's what I got to say about your portfolio. So, hey, bro, I love your channel, bruh. Is that really a portfolio? Probably not. Darn. Thank you, though. And, thanks, Blackstar, for the follow, too. And, Kaylin, I didn't skip anybody's portfolio. Anybody's. Unless I did. I don't think I did. No, maybe I did. Whoops. Sheesh. Whoopsie, whoopsie, whoopsie. Alright, Kaylin, you've been waiting. I'll do it. And no, I've already gone through your portfolio a hundred times. But, like, styles like this, like, they're very cartoonish and, like, clean. But, when you're doing vectors and stuff like this, there's, like, certain things that you want to watch out for, especially when you're doing, ones as clean as this one, especially for stickers, is, let me tone this down the stroke a little bit, is, having this, like, thing right here, and making sure that it's even, like, this side comes closer than this side, and this side almost touches, and this side doesn't. It's, like, evening out things, almost, is what you want to look out for. But everything else looks really nice. Maybe, like, fixing something that's up in here, this, line kind of just cuts down a little awkwardly, maybe, like, bring it out inside of the circle, and everything like that. So, you know, it's not really that too, like, too bad of a thing, but everything else looks really nice. Maybe, like, taking this angle and, like, pushing these two together so, like, form something, or having these more clean cut rather than, like, a circular stroke would have done a lot better of a job. But that's just, like, simple stuff you have to look out for when you're doing, like, sticker job, because they're going to be used on everything, so stuff like that. And just, like, a simplistic style for this, like, this would look good on, like, a sticker for, like, a crazy food restaurant. And I'm not going to go through all of these. I'm going to go through some. I'll go through the headers. But just, like, when you do these styles, and I can see that you're using, like, a brush, and it's, like, you're kind of like, stylized thing. But definitely, like, watching out for, like, making these things a little bit more. And adding, like, highlights and shadows for your mountains could have been a lot better. Rather than, like, having... I'll draw an example with my non-existent tablet that I have. So, like, your mountains look like this rather than when they should... God, this is about to be embarrassing. Alright, take out the black and white. Yeah.
What? Leave. Please.
Oh, yeah. You see this? These are mountains. The chat's probably going off right now. Like, what am I doing? But, this is so hard with the mouse. But, like, you see how, like, the mountains have, like, shadows and shapes? Dude, everyone's dude. I'm good. I don't know. Like, I can draw something. So, yeah, dude. That was my mom. Just tell her to leave. But, everyone just, like, bugging out. But, like, sick, for your mountains, like, you need to have, like, contrast and, like, highlights and shadows and stuff like that. So, that's that. What you guys going on about in that chat? You guys bugging out, too? You told your mom to leave my sister. That was my mom. I didn't think it was that bad. I didn't think it was that bad. I don't know what you guys are laughing about. She was staring in my doorway looking at me. Like, what am I supposed to say? Like, we want to come in? You want to do a portfolio review with me? Like, nah, bro. I asked politely. Dude, if you talk to your mom like that, you get roasted. My mom would get flamed by me if she ever talked back like that. Me and her have roast sessions all the time. Yeah, everyone's gonna get beat. So, I'm not gonna go through a lot, and I have a lot of portfolios to go through, but you get what I'm saying. Which one's on? I was on Zenka next, dude. Zenka, I'm sorry if you're waiting, but I'll work on the, yeah, dude, the shadows and the highlights. Watch Bob Ross, he goes over a lot, but totally. The manly super stylized, mom, get out of here. Dude, I told my mom to leave, and she would have smacked me. Dude, everyone's bugging out. Sheesh. It's not that bad. The forum, dude, it's exclamation point portfolio review. Yo, does someone have odd shot? You can odd shot that, whatever the hell it's called. But for Zenka, bro, I'm very familiar with their portfolio as you're talking to me in my DMs. But like stuff like this, like you want to keep like the arms pushing out of here and like keeping everything, you know, the same. Like you can't have like parts of that coming out of here and you know, the logo and stuff. Peep the tweet stream. But like stuff like this and like making these two things blend together better rather than like placing them could have done a lot better. And you just need to really work on your blending skills and like highlighting and stuff like that and making everything blend more together. So that's just like a huge thing to do. You don't want to spend too much time working on a model when you can't put the background effort into the same thing. It's like same here. You can't do this. This green tea is killing me. You can't do a rose. You can't do a rose and like keep the background with like a plexus style. Like it just doesn't like work together. So yo, everyone peep the stream. So it's just like stuff you gotta if you're gonna spend so much time on a render, bro, you gotta work on the whole entire like putting it together. It's like a huge thing. So you're welcome, Kusi, whoever linked that port, dude. White people. Yeah, dude, I'm not gonna be racist or anything, but, like, if a black person talked back to their mom, bro, like, dude, clapped. If I would've told my mom that she would've pulled down the meat cleaver. Sheesh. You guys want a little story time right now? What are you guys, like, 70 of us in this chat right now? So, my parents... How do I put this? My parents went away for one of the weekends, bro. So like I'm chilling at home alone and I have my license, I'm a senior and everything like that, and dude, mom calls me and she's like oh, what are you doing? And I was like, nothing. And she was like, oh, is like blah 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 over? And I was like, who? And she's like, oh, like blah blah blah, that's like a girl like I'm talking to. And, dude, no parents home, mom didn't care. She's like, eh. And I was talking to my brother, and he was like, dude, that's absolute bullshit. Like, if I ever did that, she would have came home, she would have whipped my ass, she would have beat me. Oh, it was so funny. Dude, you say sheesh a lot, dude. I started saying sheesh, like, this year in school, and I said it to a teacher, my college English teacher, and, he looked at me, and he was like, what? But, all right. Back to the portfolio reviews. What up, Cheetah? And one banner, that's it. But basically, you did a really good job branding this and putting it out. But when you're doing the whole background here, I would have worried about making this a little bit bigger rather than keeping like the whole corners and stuff black and white. It looked a little bit awkward. And when you're doing stuff like this, keeping these angles the same on each text could have done a lot better rather than changing them up on each thing. But that's just like my opinion, especially like right here. Like you can tell you did it here, but like everything goes down. It's just like simple stuff like that you have to worry about. And for your AVIs and logos, same thing. This actually looks pretty dope, but this logo, try not to like keep flipping stuff back and forth. It doesn't look that good unless it's like a minimalist style. But you know, everything like that. Yo, she's low-key watching this. Dude, my mom's probably downstairs watching the stream, like probably like sitting. She's probably like writing down notes to like yell at me when she gets home or when she gets back up here. So, your stuff is 2D, 2D, 3D, I love 2D. But, same thing as I said before, just, like, watch out for these big black boxes around your stuff, and, just blending stuff better, and working on your models and renders and stuff like that could do a lot more, and, not overkilling it, excuse me, with, like, color corrections and stuff like that. And when you're doing styles like this, and this, try not to, like, match them, because, like, 2D is so much different than 3D, so you really, sincerely need to watch out for stuff like that, 100%. So, Ferric or Frostby? Yo, Frostby, you were in the chat earlier. I was talking to you. But, where's the port review link, bro? Exclamation point port. I'll type it real quick. I was like, it's almost fall off my chair. Portfolio review. Yo, I'll be linking that chat. Thanks for viewing my port, bro. Share it out to the stream and thank you on Twitter. And, dude, you're welcome for the tips. Just like simple stuff like that you gotta worry out for. So, everything like that. And, let's get right into it. So this is Ryan Bach or Ferric or Ferric, and right wing ad poll. So, ooh, I like that shirt. I don't know if he made this shirt or not, but it's a dope idea and a dope concept. I kind of like that. rather than, like, the whole Trump thing looks really dope, but the whole motion blur and Gaussian blur that you use is a little bit too much, of course. You know, I would just tone that down, of course, a little bit. But with your 3D style right here, you did a really good job blending stuff together. I would have added a little bit more lighting in the bottom of this logo because of this little light source you have going on. And this like little flare right here just looked a little bit awkward. Not too much of a fan. But, you know, when you get down towards here, this starts looks pretty cool. It's like a very clean, flat design, like minimalist style put together. But that cloud just there just doesn't really match the whole entire scene of a rose and, you know, a white, black and or a white and red theme. But, like, simple stuff like that, just you just gotta worry out for. And for your esports team logos, these are actually done very well. So, that's from a tutorial of Swerve, so I can't really say. But, like, this is doing well. And this is very basic, but it's very clean, so I'll give you a good job on that one, homie, for sure. So, don't gotta worry, dude. 43 ports? I'm gonna have to crank these out. Advertisements, headers? Of course. Best art of the night. I made the shirt, dude. Good job on that shirt. It's a dope concept, for sure. We need something in the background, some sound. Here. Shout out to YouTube if I get copyrighted, because I'm gonna be pissed. Oh, I know what I can put on. I'm on a new level. Calmly waiting for my art to be shown. Yo, Cosmic, I'm trying, homie. I'm gonna get some music bumping. We're gonna crank these out for sure. Use Spotify. No, it's not like... Can you guys still hear it? Yay, nay? I want a yay in the chat. Yay in the chat or nay in the chat? Tanner Fox, though? Tanner Foxes. But, put some dope ass music, dude. Cranked, what up? Barely. Yo, Duke, the stream is gonna be uploaded on YouTube tomorrow morning. 20s and 30s and volume is good. Not that much. Nay, nay, no, no, yay. Dude, I'm getting everything. 5%? You guys are killing me. That better? You gotta like make sure you can hear me. I'm not trying to scream. Too much? Oh, Lord. Perfect? Yeah, you guys are killing me. 30? 60? What do you mean? I'm gonna stop touching. You guys are freaking me out. We hear you? I hope you hear me. Yo, we're just chilling watching the stream. Yo, we're going through some portfolios right now. So, Quinn, or Dawson, you got a very nice style for sure. For this text right here, I would just definitely, the stream will only show for 5 seconds. However, that's your internet, brother. 45 is good. All right, I'm keeping it. But, totally, that's like this text right here. Just keep it the same. You know, don't really flip each letter around. Just kind of keep it on the slant with the side. And I like how you created the depth fields with this blurred out leaf. And, same thing with this one. You did a really good job putting all the stuff together. Maybe adding some more leaves on the other side and stuff. So, same thing. This looked a little awkward. It's kind of placed on the left-hand side with this background stock, but you could have moved it over a little bit and maybe blurred this leaf a little bit more. Just like simple stuff like that. And same thing with this one, but this is done very well. And overusing the same stock, like back and back and back again, of course, is a little weird. I should get a pop filter. I actually have one on my mic, but I'm really like loud. And so, whatevs. Same thing with this one, bro. You did a really good job on this one, but it's just repetitive stocks that you're using, so you always have to watch out for that one. And, you know, it's just, like, simple stuff like that. Like, overusing the same stock, just, like, you get a little crazy. And for your advertisements, of course, this is really good. And just, like, the text right here is a little awkward, but you should maybe add some shadows on those watermelons and, like, sizing everything. But it's a really dope idea for everything else. For the advertisements, of course, maybe making the shadow a little bit less and matching the shape of the logo could have done a little bit better. The text is fine, and that's the end of the portfolio. And someone's asking me to actually link the portfolios, and I'm actually going to do that. But there you go. That's the portfolio link. Did you make your signature logo with a tablet? I didn't make it, but it was done with a tablet 100%. I don't think you can pen tool something like that so clean. So... what is this music? Juicy J feeling like Obama, and now we're about to bomb. Alright, 11 is Titan. I know it's bad. Dude, you guys are like... I hate when you guys like say that. But, why is it so loud now? But, basically, for this... What was it, anime? I think I said it right. For like stuff like this, you need to like make sure that everything looks clean, like cleanly placed. Like this one's done really well, and also this one. But like when you get up to like this Mickey Mouse one, is like creating these shadows under the feet a little bit to kind of create the little depth field and stuff like that. Just a little bit better. But you need to like worry about creating like lighting and stuff. You did good here. And having like a light source and like cast shadows and stuff like that could do like a big thing to it. And just like basic things like this, maybe making it a little bit brighter and not overkilling it so much with CCs and edit bowl looks could do a huge difference for your work. 100%, dog. So. It's just something you gotta worry about. It's loud because it's rad. Ghost stories. I'll tell you a ghost story. So, Nick Tracy is next, or Dola. And for his headers, he does a lot of manipulation ones. And if you get copyright, if I get copyright, I'm pissed. Just kidding. And so, manipulation headers, I think I'm saying the word right. Overall, this one's really done nice. Reminds me of like, was it 300? But the logo is really big, maybe toning that logo down a little bit more. And the bird really creates a depth field between everything. Like, same with here, is having like these birds, like, really creates like the distance between everything. And when you get to like stuff like this, it's just like a little bit weird. Maybe changing up that little bevels and stuff like that, making them more hard edges, could have done a lot better. And your thumbnails, I can't really say much about thumbnails, but they're done very nicely. And it's something I would click on just because it has the big word on top of it. And it's just something that you want to be a part. And advertisements, or not avatars, this one's done really nice. I really like that gold style, so good job on that one, bro. You just gotta worry about, you know, making like those shadows and stuff like that, but you're doing a really good job like creating that cast shadow and stuff. So Unreal Graphics is next. Are you guys talking about the chat? Yo. Sponsor me. Imagine. Dude, imagine I got sponsored by Dunkin' Donuts. Holy shit. I go from like 130 pounds to like 600 in like 5 seconds. That would be 11 followers. Oh! You guys are killing it right now, tweeting out that stream. Who made that? I like that text. Where am I? Dude, I'm trying my best to get through these 100%. I go through Unreals yet? I don't think so. So, Unreal, just styles like this, like, maybe now would be the time to use CCs, but, like, making that smoke a little bit darker and the fire a little bit brighter and, like, going on top of the tiger could have done a lot better. And shadows on that text is a lot of kind of stuff you want to worry about. Or, like, these scratch marks and kind of stuff like that. Totally worrying about. Same thing here is the shadows and stuff like that. But you did create a nice depth field with these leaves and stuff. So... same thing with this one, just repeating things, like flipping them like that. It looks a little bit awkward, but you did a good job creating this like little spaces for the text. And I really don't know what to say about this one. I'm not too sure. Maybe if you made that logo a little bit more white, the black just offsets everything really awkwardly, especially because there's a stroke around that circle. Just looks a little awkward. And for your banners, you need light sources. I hope you guys like understanding that when you put light sources down, that you need to have like light somewhere coming, like hovering over something. If you have like a light up here, you want it to like shine down on top of things rather than like having something else. Like, I'll explain it to you guys really quickly. And I'm making a whole video on this when I get my laptop and my tablet, when I purchase it, but it's gonna be really hard for me to draw this for you guys. But let's say we have a box, and let's just say it's three-dimensional. Oh, God, it's not going to work that way. Nope. How do I want to do this? All right. Let's say we have a three-dimensional box. And we have a plain floor. Oh, God. A plain floor that goes through it like this. So let's just say that you guys are worrying about your modeling and your renders. So this is your Cinema 4D render right here. I'll put a C. And your lighting is coming up from like here. So you have your lighting shining down right here. And it's going to be the same thing for your Cinema 4D render. If you have like your logo right here and the light's coming down from here, the top part is going to be the most lit and the bottom part's going to be the most dark. So for an example, you guys have this kind of stuff. When the light hits here, it's going to shine everything here, and it's going to create that shadow. I got to do this a different way, maybe. It creates that shadow through here, like that. And especially because the backside's a lot darker. And you know, right here is going to be the most light, so that's going to be really white. And it's going to get like darker towards the edge, and the light's going to bounce off, and then it's going to hit right here, and it's just going to create that big shadow. So you really got to worry about that kind of stuff, especially here. Creating that light, making the light come down, and like creating the shadows right here, so... 100%. So logos, really well. It's just like simple stuff like this. If I can copy this image, is actually exactly the part I wanted. Is making sure that this ruler line lines up with something. So does this one, and so does this one. So like you guys can see when I take these rulers and put them down, you see the difference between these lines, and it starts to like really like ache in your mind that like it happened that way. But you really gotta worry about when you're doing logo design is making everything flow together 100%. So that's just my tip for everyone with the logos and stuff like that. So Unreal overall, man, good job with the portfolio. It's just like simple tips like that for everyone that you want to worry about. So Pape, your portfolio is actually next. I saw your work around actually. I wonder who retweeted it. I saw your work on Twitter somewhere. I'm gonna go through your paint it headers. But it's like the same thing I've been talking about. You know, everything is done really well. You really have like your own like style to be everything together. But just like creating like lighting would really like lighting and shadows would really make your work like probably like 10 times better. Like you can see you did like little scratch marks and stuff like that, but if you can have like shadows or like lighting coming through here and like shadows getting lit under here, and same with the gun, like making like the hair a little bit brighter and like darker right here and stuff like that, could have been like a lot better. And it's like stuff like that right here, having like the back of the mouth darker, having like a tongue or something like that, could have done like a lot bigger of a difference. And same thing with here, like you did a good job creating like the light and shadow, but you can tell like right here that the lighting is coming from here. There wouldn't be a shadow being casted right down from here. It'd be casted behind this piece of fur, or be casted behind the mouth or behind the chin. So you're like understanding it slowly, but I would just definitely take this whole entire thing inside of your illustrations. And same thing right here. I'm not gonna look at that one, but your lighting is done really well here, and then just like adding shadows done really well. And for people that are doing this, you don't need to add shadows to something that's not there. I hope you guys know that, like adding shadows to something that's not there looks a little awkward. And it's a really dope logo design or t-shirt design. I would just worry about making the stroke a little bit less around that text, 100%. I'm not gonna go through the whole portfolio, I got a lot to go through. So. Alright, Styles, you're next. Thank you guys all for the follows and stuff like that. We've been getting mad follows lately. Sorry, I haven't been like recognizing them. Like Kitty, Dubstep, Killer Gaming, Mona, Mew, Ham, Alonzo, dude, all of you guys, thank you. But basically for this style, we have this like simple clean 2D ones, and it's worrying about how everything lines up is a big thing, and making sure everything works together well. Like right here, not so much of like this working together with this, but these two texts look very well together, especially since you have the shadows coming down and like the lighting coming off and stuff. But once you get to like styles like this, it's 100% like making that transparency maybe a little less, or having that shadow a little less could have done a lot better of a job. And like stuff like this, it's a good idea, but I would just try to create a little bit more rather than just flipping these squares around. And this is a good example of what I was talking about. So if everyone has make these water backgrounds and stuff like that, my back's starting to hurt. Just like creating this like a bigger difference, like I can see you try to blend it right here a little bit, maybe making that line a little bit thicker and this a big drop and like a little less dark. And then overall right here, man, this is probably your strongest work on your portfolio, 100% is this. And the only reason is because how clean it is and how much of a esports community would have rather used this. So 100%, dude, I'm gonna hit 1k followers. Yeah, dude, you would have thought if I was to hit 1k on Twitch, I would stream every day. I don't care, I'd stream me drinking iced tea. I'd sit down and chat full 100 kids just drinking. Did I already check lately amused? I don't think so. I'm doing Dom right now. I mean views. Oh, dude, views. I'm about to say it, dude. 1K followers. All right. So we got Dom next, and also known as DK, I guess. And basically, overall, like, these are really clean styles, and I really like this one. But like, when you're doing stuff like this, you just have to worry about. It looks really familiar. Oh, that's my top five. But like stuff like this, you're doing a really good job of making that just like this little burst that's coming out of nowhere. This looks a little awkward, maybe taking that rocket launcher a little bit out or something like that. But creating the depth fields with these bullets and like hands and stuff like that looks really well. And just this little stuff like this, maybe that CC is a little bit too much, but right here he did a really good job how he like reaching around and grabbing it. But I really like this piece just because of how like the circles get smaller and gets more behind bushes. If you guys like understand what I'm talking about. Did I skip you? Nine works. I don't think I skipped anybody. I'm trying not to. I can go back and look. So. But like right here, you can see that things are getting back into space, going behind other things. But really good job, you know, creating that whole depth field and stuff like that. So I'm gonna give you a really good job on that one, bro. So we're on going to 17. Nah, I didn't skip anybody. Sorry. Maybe you're next. You next? Donut's next. GG, bro. This is a chill stream. I'm trying my best to be chill. I'm out of drink, though. I'm kind of pissed. Gross. Alright, Donut. I hope you're ready. I'm about to get flamed. I'm feeling it. Just kidding. So, with your YouTube banners, it's the same thing I've been talking about with everyone inside this portfolio reviews, is making sure that everything works together well. Like, having a black background with a white background and all this kind of stuff that doesn't really work well together. And, of course, having, like, random shapes. I mean, this is probably your logo, but, like, making things work together better and creating that, kind of sense of feel and sense of, like, you know what you're doing. But right here, you did a good job, you know, creating like the logo, the text, and like this, like everything worked together well. You know, you did create the space, and it's like stuff like this. It feels like it's halfway done. And just if you guys are, like, have like questions, like questionable about your kind of stuff, never just throw something in your portfolio if you think it's done. Like, you like make sure you're happy with the outcome. And right here, just like when you're doing something for FaZe Clayster, or Clayster or anything. But make sure you're using his team that he's currently in, like Gfinity. That's a FaZe jersey, but like right here he's using the Envy jersey. Just like stuff like that, you want to make sure you know, make sure everything's consistent between everything. But just like simple stuff like that, and of course, as I said before, you know, making sure that they're all on the same team and that nothing works together well. And when you're doing styles like this, making sure that the white doesn't look too awkwardly placed and it ends too differently. It would have gone behind this guy's head if it was anything like that. And the repetitive versions of throwing Twitter headers in, just a little awkward to be like in a place inside of a portfolio like that. But like right here, you did a good job creating that big light source to, you know, create your eye drawn to the logo. So you did understand that pretty well. And very clean right here. That was very simplistic and clean style that looked very well. And just like, it's like a lot of the same stuff that I was talking about, you know. I don't want to go over and say the same thing over and over again to you guys, but it's just the same thing as making sure everything's in the same team, that everything complements each other back really well, and just everything like that. 100%. So. McLovin. You here, buddy? My drink. Dude, I love your channel. You make great content. Thanks, bro. I'm trying my best. This winter, actually, if you guys, there's like 80 of us, or 60 of us watching, this winter, my brother's coming home from college, and we're gonna make, like, webisodes every weekend, like one every weekend of me skiing. If you guys don't know, I'm, like, a national skier, so it'd be, like, really dope to do, I think. Like, if you guys ever watch, like, Tanner Fox or Scotty Kramer, Adam LZ, like, videos like that. So, dude, this is you? Is this you, McLovin? But, to get right into it, or the Twitter headers, because I'm not going to go through all of these. I see you have a lot of stuff. I'm just going to go through like one section per person. Are you on Skype person or Discord person? I usually use Skype. I don't really fuck around with Discord just because it's a little weird. But with your style right here, I like this a lot, but I would have added just a little more color and maybe a little bit more. In Texas, it hasn't snowed in 6 years. Whew. Dude, I would have been miserable. But it was totally creating these colors would have done a lot better. Right here, you did a good job creating that the aesthetic Tokyo pixel style. And with this logo right here, it looks a little bit awkward, but you could have fixed that really quickly with like a different color or something like that. Just like simple stuff like this. Creating shadows from this logo could have done a lot better, and making sure that light hits it, which you did a really good job. How it's darker here and it's lighter here, you understood that concept a little bit better. And as adding text like this, I would just worry about not putting that in there, to be honest, because it looks a little bit awkward. And just kind of placing a layer style on top of something won't make it clean necessarily. Making sure these stocks match everything, like these little swirly stocks don't look too well with everything. And you really understand the whole like shadow idea, shadow concept. But when you're doing stuff like this, I would just totally not flip these styles. I would just totally keep it the same, work with what you got, and like just like simple stuff. Like, I don't know how to explain it to you guys really, but making sure that you're not using your clan PSD 100% into this. Just so like, make sure you have like separate logos and stuff like that. Same thing here. That little like using like the black cell render or black border for that logo looks a little bit awkward. And it's just like something like that you have to worry about 100%. So, Slender, you're up. Have you done your portfolio at Cosmic? I don't believe so. Not yet. Tanner Fox and Madu, because my name is Tanner. That works that way too. Dude, Austin, Texas? Sheesh. Christmas Day was 70. Dude, Christmas Day was mad hot in New York too. I don't think it snowed here. I don't know what I did for Christmas last year. Yeah, I do. I asked for Fallout 4. Christmas came. I didn't get Fallout 4. I was pissed. But I found it. My name. Okay, say my name when you see it so I can hear you. Alright, bro. For sure. This is Slender Sayer Quim. And it's simple like anime styles like this. You did a really good job on making sure that everything kind of flows together properly. But making sure the colors work together and the styles is a big thing. Can't add these like swirly stocks when you're doing a half tone and paint splatter. Simple stuff like that. And like the font choice is a little bit awkward here. And just like simple stuff like this. I hope you guys are starting to understand that like you can't have like a very cartoonish text and a very bold text like together, or have a weird background, like a very blurred out background with a very cartoonish style. Just like stuff that doesn't complement each other, especially when you get to like towards bigger things. And if I was you guys, I would just totally throw your Twitch graphics into a different side of your portfolio. Same thing with thumbnails. But you did a good job with your thumbnail, especially this one of like creating that what you're gonna be watching and like a clickbait kind of spiel to it. So good job on that one, man. Like, you're doing a good job with your thumbnails, but it's time you need to like understand that you can't use like different kind of fonts. Like, Here's a good example. The very cartoonish font and the very bold. Like, if we go into Photoshop, I really gotta take out these files. Let's open the text tool. Like, let's say we're writing a book, and write the end. Let me find a good font to use for you guys to show you the example. Here you go. Like, you guys can't really, like, these, like, don't really work together, if you understand what I'm saying. Like, these don't really flow together too much. So, it's, like, something like this you have to really worry about 100% is, like, something like that, for sure. It's making those texts kind of flow together. I hope you understand. I'm not trying to be mean to you or anything, like, saying that. But, totally. What's the text in the one that the letters are spaced weird? I'm not too sure. Yo, how's my day? Day's going extremely well. I'm very tired. I don't know where my glasses are. I can barely see. You're just sitting here listening, bro. Sometimes it's what you gotta do. You gotta get knowledge. You can't just sit here and do whatever you want. You gotta get knowledge somehow. My boxers are up my butt. Same. same. Haven't got a good snow in Seattle for 5. Rip. What? You guys are killing me with this whole snow thing. Alright, ZG, you're next. Photos? Aw, dude, I got so hyped with photography. I was like, yes! Can you make a list of fonts you use one day? I might do a font pack. Iffy. Iffy for sure.
Notifications.
Famous. I'm a genius, dude. I'm pretty sure that the font is Olympic branding. Is that the Bentley logo? Close to the Bentley? Nah, was it Bugatti? Not trying to expose anybody, but come on now. Very similar. Stuff like this, you gotta worry about like being very similar to stuff, but it's very clean. E? Yeah, E for sure. Stuff like that. Ooh. If you made this pixel by pixel, bro, more power to you. 100% dope, but if you like made it in Photoshop and stuff like that, it's a little bit iffy. But cartoon styles, I would just try to keep it cartoonish and not add more realistic renders of stuff. And using mock-ups and stuff like this in your banner is a little bit awkward. So you gotta like worry about that, of course. And just like making these like little cast shadows and like lighting from here. Like the lighting would come in here, it would kind of like make this a little bit more lighter. And maybe like right here a little bit more. But if you understand what I'm talking about, then you pretty much know what's going on. Same thing here, very clean style, very clean style, of course. So just stuff that you have to worry about. And, dude, pixels are annoying to work with, so more power to you for that kind of stuff for sure. So, same thing, I can't really do this, but making sure that these are high quality and not low quality images is a very good resource, definitely, to get into. What do you say? Any feedback slash improvements other than the harsh CCs I already use? Yo, 9? 9. You hear, brother? Exposed? Dude, I'm not exposing anybody. Who's linking selfie chats? Who is this? Who's getting banned? Yeah. Yeah, you're lucky it was mine. You guys are mad chill, actually. No one's linking shit. Other than your channel, what channel would you highly recommend to learn from? CISO, Rated, Swerve, Armageddon, Will Patterson, Flow. I don't know. Chill. Alright. 9, I don't know if you're here, but you're up next. I already opened it. Yeah, dude, you're here. Alright, sweet. Wanted to make sure. Don't ban me, Esper. Dude, I'm just kidding. Alright, so for this kind of stuff, this is exactly what I'm talking about for you guys. Like, you're starting to understand that this shadow right here you have to have, but these shadows on the text look a little bit awkward, especially with those little black dots everywhere, and this font choice a little bit better. It's a little too skinny to match this little big bold fonts, and it's like the harsh CCs that you said to look out for that you already used. You know, you understand what you're doing wrong, so just like stuff like that, and maybe taking this out a little bit and making these eyes glow a little bit more could have helped. But once you get to here, you're starting to understand that the lighting source is coming up, shooting around. The displacement on the text is a little bit awkward. And the same thing I've been saying with font choice, of course, is a really thing to worry about. Using clan PSDs for renders that you can't make in Cinema 4D, really big hassle. And you can see like right here, we gotta open up this little line right here. That looks a little bit awkward. I would just try to take that out if possible. If not, then it's okay. But when you get to your 3D work, dude, the mood switches high key. Holy. Really good, but it's like stuff like this you have to worry about. If this bullet is going above this K and below this C-U-L, then that bullet has to be in a very weird angle. So it's just like stuff like that you have to really worry about. And everything else looks really nice. The lighting is good. Everything else looks really sick, especially like right here and stuff. You have the lighting coming off. Maybe making these glow a little bit more could have helped, but creating that depth of field, of course, very nice. Same thing here. And you already said that your CCs are a little too bright, so you understand that you need to chill it out, like especially with the ones that get towards the bottom. But at least you know what you're looking for. So definitely like font choice and like making things like work together. Like, I'll draw you guys a little example, because I'm a god at drawing, you know how it is. So wait, I need like a 5 or 6. If you have, I'll draw a box again because I'm gonna draw in boxes. If you have a box and you have the word, or you have like a letter A, and the A, oh that's really bad, goes like behind the box like that. You'll get the shadow going up right here. But if you, come on, if you have the A that goes above the box like that, it'll create the shadow in the box. So you just have to worry about that. The shadow comes from the A, depending on where the light source is. If the light source is coming down like this, hits here, it creates a shadow here. And it's like stuff like that you have to worry about for sure. But you're doing a good job. Just the whole shadows and lighting things are really a thing to look out for 100%. So Daniel C. Creates up next. And everyone's talking in the chat. I want to give it a little read real quick. I ain't looking to get banned from Bearish Chat. Nah, dude, I'm not banning everybody. I was just chilling. Didn't copy the Bugatti logo. I made the red one and just added the things. I wasn't saying that you copied it. I was just saying that it was very similar. I didn't say that you're like going out to copy it. It was just like something you have to worry about. Is when you make logos like that. Like, you're never gonna make a very original logo. Like, let's go to my portfolio. I could 100% find a logo similar to mine. Ready? What was it? An E? Ready? E diamond logo. Watch this. Ready? There's gonna be stuff similar, 100%. Like, maybe mine's a little bit different because it's more of a gem shape, but like, there's gonna be things similar to your work. I didn't say you're copying it, I was just saying that you just gotta watch out for being very similar. Just something you have to worry about because some people are gonna be scumbags and they call you out about it. I'm going to bed. I'll probably be back later because you're going to be here for a while. I'm going to be here probably for another like hour or so for sure. If you do miss it out, the whole thing's going to be on YouTube and like on it tomorrow morning. But who is this? This is Daniel. Daniel C. Creates, bro, with the Stormtrooper illustration. The same thing I've been saying with mascot logos, you guys have been watching it. The whole kind of shadows and the casting and stuff like this really needs to make more sense. I'm going to take it back into the Photoshop that I've been drawing some nice pictures with. I need a different color. I need like blue. I don't like a blue. Yeah. So I don't know where the light's coming from, but it looks like you're trying to make it come from like here. But when it hits here, it's going to be at the brightest right at this thing, and then it's going to burst out and create the shadow here. But the overlap of the helmet will create this kind of thing. Then the eyes will create a shadow, the lips will create a shadow, this little thing, whatever the hell this is called, will create a shadow, this will create a shadow. It's not like you're gonna have this all big like swoop shadow like you see on those like really big advertisements, stuff like that. That doesn't really actually happen. So when the illustrations come out, you just really gotta worry about making sure everything pops together like that. For UI designs, I'm not really one to critique these, but they look very clean. Maybe taking out this logo could have done a little bit better, but for sure, stuff like this is really clean, 100%. This is something really good to know for website design, 100%. Who created my my logo? Matt D Designs did. So I would go check him out. I have a new one being made. I haven't really sent it to anybody yet, so trying to keep that on the DL until I get my new intro, logo, banner, header, all that stuff done. Alright, so this is Andrew Reed, or just Reed overall. And for the BPI advertisements, the text choice is a little bit awkward to place it up there like that. Maybe making this a blend a little bit better, or having this like blur out a little bit better, could have done a lot better of a job. These clouds look a little bit awkward, and the lighting is like a little weird. Did I say Maddie B? No, Maddie D. Sheesh. But like stuff like that, G Fuel advertisements, making this wrap around your logo, just like shadows. I really don't want to keep going through these portfolios. I keep telling you guys the same thing. Just like stuff like this. I like the renders and stuff, but like making sure that things match a little well. Like this table looks a little bit awkward, and like these all don't match in a sense. So it's just like matching stuff, definitely for sure. Shirt wise, very simplistic, but you branded it very clean. This reminds me of Dace Dixon, so not too sure how that's going. But you understand what I'm saying. Lux, Matt Doyle, yeah, see? I guess saying Lux for. Yeah, I know who Ace Designs is. He used to be my thing. Yo, thank you, Nine, for linking that. For team headers, oh lord, I don't want to get me started. If you're doing a team header like this, make sure all four of them are in one file. Five of them are on one file. It's just a huge thing that you don't want to put. I don't want to click through the same thing with a different name. With this, creating more of a shadow could have helped better, and taking out these sun rays and like extra lighting that doesn't necessarily need to be there. Something you always got to worry about. For logos, same thing I've said. You gotta find a light source. It's really helpful out. You're just not making random shading. But I do like how you added a little hand shading right here. But basically, like this little thing right here, I would just try to push out and maybe make it a little bit more. But I understand what you're trying to do for sure. Make that shadow right here. But logos, same thing. It's just like, this is very creative. I like this one a lot. But just like, making sure that everything's a vector and everything matches together well, and that you can make it a black and white, but also like a silver one. And right here is good. Maybe taking out that, I can see that the hair color is not a true black, it's a very off black, but you can see the shadow goes through the whole entire thing. That's just something that you won't really want to worry about. So it's like simple stuff like that, but you're starting to understand. Like repeating logos, it's a big thing in portfolios, especially because of this. There's no S in portfolio review to link your thing. But repeating logos is something you want to worry about. And making sure that things work well together. This like this idea works well together, but the face is like a little awkward. The anatomy of the structure of the face is a little bit weird. So, I hope you understand what I'm saying. I went through the BPI advertisement a little bit too fast. I'm sorry, man. I'll explain it to you a little bit better right now then. Can you like Maddie D's YouTube link? I don't think he has a YouTube. I don't think he just makes it. I got inspiration from Days Designs and that Cloud 9 one, but that was my earliest. Yeah, I feel you. I'll just take it out in Photoshop real quick to explain what I was talking about. So right here, it's just like, I think it would look a lot better if you necessarily had the ending of the thing rather than it just blending out like this, because it looks a little bit weird just having this like swoop down. You can see the defined edging where it ends. But this cloud just looks a little bit weird, maybe adding like a little bit of lighting here. Like simple things that could have changed the outcome, necessarily speaking, since I am a design freak. I understand how some things work, but if you create like a big light source, like right here and maybe like right here, like something like that could have like brightened up the whole entire thing, made the perspective a lot nicer, and made everything a lot like cleaner to look at, if you understand what I'm talking about. I hope so. Just go back through that for him. The next is Brandon S. And more advertisements. Again, I'm not trying to go through everyone's exact input, but when you're doing stuff like this, just totally don't put things in your portfolio that are copied from advertisements or tutorials. Same thing with here. Just the shadows need to be a lot darker, and things need to be blended out a lot more. It looks like you kind of rushed your style into this, and just like stuff like that, you have to understand. Same thing with the revamps. I've seen this before. I'm not too sure if you're the one that made it. I think you are. Making the clouds a little bit more scattered, because clouds want to form such an exact position, and it's just like simple stuff like that you have to worry about. Making these lap the same way. This wouldn't just drop straight into this thing. It probably would have go over it, and then it would go over this. And maybe this is correctly because it's under, but it's like something like that you have to worry about. Creating these glow a little bit more, the lighting, and everything like that. You know, this light source is what I was talking about for you, Reed, if you guys can understand. I didn't skip anybody. I went through that one already. I just went back to go to Reed because I was finished one. Making a light source pop out like that, like a sun. That's exactly what I was talking about. And no, I already went through Andrew's, I believe. Right? Yeah, I went through it. I talked about that a little bit more. Orange. Yo, you here, buddy?
Yo, my back is killing me.
Dude. Link for submitting ports, please. If you just type in exclamation point portfolio review,
100% we'll get in there.
Yo, someone refresh the page for me real quick. How many followers we got? Probably like 260? No, more. You guys are killing it with the follows. Lux followed. Kusi, Killer Gaming, TDXP. Thank you all. Dude, you have a 5-page paper due tomorrow, and I haven't... Dude, I have so much homework. All right, so I didn't... Like, I had someone over. They didn't leave until, like, 5 maybe. Made my video about the port review. Just got my link working on my monitor. Drove the Dunkin', got food, drinks. 268? All right, 58. But, like, totally didn't cross my mind. I'm downstairs talking to my mom, right? I'm sitting there, filling out this community service thing that they do for my government class. And it hit me, bro. I have statistics homework. I have a college English essay to write. I was like, oh, like, sheesh, bro. Like, I'm going to be up until, like, 3 again. I was pissed. All right, Orange. You ready, buddy? Yo, I'm about to put on glasses. I'm about to be a douche. Dude, it's so hot, man. I'm going to look. Yeah. Just kidding. Yo, I'm 50 so I can start, can't start for a while. Sheesh. Alright, bro, I'm gonna bust these out. We have 50? Alright, logo folios. Let's go Orange. With this, savage. With this, I'm gonna show you exactly what I mean. Won't even explain. I'm just gonna show you. Take out those rulers, man, and line these up like this. And 100%, it's gonna make your work so much better. In a sense that when you do this now, you literally make a new layer, and you just look at this. Ready? And like just like copy it, and like just like this. I don't know where I was going with this one, but like just like this, like copy this thing so it's a hard edge. Like Allier's logo has a very hard edge and stuff like that. So totally is exactly what I was talking about. Try your best to do something like that. Is there more than one? I'm sorry if I just... I'm clicking so many monitors right now. It's bugging me out. For this one is just making the spaces bigger and making the size work better. I would just go through more rough drafts and more briefs to get this stuff done. If you guys are interested, I'm making a video very soon about how to put together a logo, how to create your own logo design, like my logo process. So you guys would be interested in that. For this one, it's just like, if you're gonna buy a shoe, you gotta sell a shoe. Don't make an advertisement like this and just have like the shoe falling apart. You want to like sell the shoe and make it a lot more popping up in your face. And when you guys like stuff like this, I love The Flash, 100%, best movie ever, or best TV show, gonna be the best movie. But making stuff match is very key. And making this text not so far out, if that makes sense. Maybe like closer, a little under, like right here. But making this lighting come out a little bit more, maybe lighting up the text, the rows a little bit. And stuff like this. If you guys are using Cinema 4D to make this, it's little like rivets. I would just try to smooth out, especially because it's smoother on this end and not so smooth on this. Same thing as I said, make sure that these are very clean edge cuts that you guys can use your pen tool for. And it's a lot of things that, stuff like that. Same thing here I've been talking about, creating those shadows and everything like that. I'm not going to go through all of them, but I hope you're understanding what I'm talking about. So, there you go, Orange. Marcus, you're up, brother. I'm pretty bad at GFX. I can watch someone make an amazing thing and be like, yeah, I know everything he did. I can make it, but then I open a blank canvas and I got an idea, and it turns out trash. And that works for everybody. Like, here we go. You feel me, bro? Guys, please link to submit. Dude, it's exclamation point portfolio review. It's not what I was looking for. I follow a bunch of people on Behance. I love going through people's work. Did you do formally? I'm not too sure. I don't think so. I go through this stuff. Like, Come on now. Like, I know I'm only 16, but, like, seriously? Like, what? Like, right, this, wait, look at this. Like, how, what? Like, stuff like that blows my mind. And then I get down, like, I'm about to make the coolest work ever. Open up my stupid canvas. Or, in art, bro. I'm gonna do my, about to do my paint project. We have to draw a face. Everyone's drawing, like, their anatomy sketch like this. Like, they're looking solid. Like, they're getting, like, the lines down. Like, the eye side, the circle for the head, the eyebrows, the eyes, the mouth, the nose, some hair. There you go. Some big-ass ears. Maybe, like, a skinny neck, but, like, python shoulders like that. All right? Like, I get, like, nice stuff. And then I open my canvas, and it's, like... Nah, but seriously, like, I understand where you guys are coming from. This is Marcus, and really dope style. I really like this, especially because it illuminates the water. I really like this actually. The text render is a little bit weird, but definitely something that you have to worry about. Making stuff like this, like a Stranger Things, it's very easy to make these, but I like how you made the style. Maybe a little less blurry could have helped. Same thing with this one, as I said before, is making the text a little bit better, maybe more kind of a part of this. Maybe the scan lines could have been over the text a little bit more. But perfect right here. Really good job, man. The little blur, the little RGB splits a little bit too much, but the shadow of everything looks really dope. Very trippy style. Same thing with this one. Like I said, guys, you want to sell the product. And if I was looking to buy a keyboard and I saw this, I would totally think about it. I'd be this... It's a very futuristic keyboard, 100%. Maybe I'll think about it and stuff like that. You want to sell the product, not just, like, make a design for it. So, you love that Pablo font? It's a nice font. You guys like that drawing? I did do Daniel C. Creates, bro. That was a lot earlier. Oh, my back is killing me. Jesus. Yo, I love that Pablo font. Is there any specific good clean 2D tutorials? Not necessarily. CISO has a lot of 2D stuff. I don't really do a lot of 2D tutorials. I do a lot of, like, designer tips and designer things that you guys should learn about. I'm not here to teach you guys how to open Photoshop and make something. I really want to, like, get you guys more knowledgeable on how things work. So this is Symbol Arts and Only Banner. Really quick, these black bars are killing me. Everyone's portfolio. I'm going to start bugging out soon. But, like, stuff like this is creating the shadows. There's no shadow for this thing, or there is for the text. The shadows wouldn't be so deep and dark through these corners. That's probably the CC you're using, but it's like stuff like that you have to worry about. But for this one, when you're doing like the E for everyone, just add it in the corner. Don't put it in the middle of the text. It's like simple stuff like that you have to worry about. But for this one, you did a good job with the whole is the Game of Thrones or whatever this movie is or TV show. But the text looks really nice. These look pretty nice placed here, but this whole block with the designer inside of it looks a little awkward. Just like something like you have to worry about is matching stuff like that. And the same thing with the CC. So you really got to worry about overusing it because you're going to start doing some overkill and stuff like that. So, yo, Cosmic, you're up. So I'm going to say Cosmic. I'm going to wait for him to respond in the chat. Everyone get ready. Just waiting for Bear Art School to open in 2020. Dude, nah, I'm running for president in 2020. I know who Quezzy is, not Krez. Yo, Cosmic, you ready? You ready? Dude, you're hyped. Alright, oh, Twitch. I love Twitch. I think that's Dracula. Is it Dracula? By the way, stream, don't get mad. I sunk it to movie? Is it? Alright, so this is just it? Alright, so shit, our LOL viewers don't get copied down at work, thanks. We can open them. For the intermission screens and stuff like this, it's very basic. It's just like I would try to add some more text, of course. You know, like right here, you say come back later, but before you go, hit that follow button. This, like, the text choice is a little bit weird, maybe making a little bit more of a bold font and keeping that background a little bit cleaner. But I like how you added the border and the little blocks. It really creates, like, he's a very simplistic guy. Like, when you guys make stuff for someone, you want to present their graphics the same way they would want to present themselves. Rather than if you were going to do something for a very, like, hardcore rock person, you want, like, a dark, very red, and a very explosive theme. If you're doing something for someone's kind of, like, mellow and chill, kind of 2D style like this really work out well and stuff like that. And when you make these panels a little bit bigger, I would do a little bit more wider rather than larger like that. But overall, man, it's a really good style. You know, it's something you really want to know how to do is make Twitch packages. You make a lot of money with it, and it's also a very requested thing. So, for sure. I hope that really helped you with that kind of stuff. I know you waited a long time. So, Lately Amused, I saw you talking in the chat about it. If I did yours, you're up next. So, just let me know in the chat when you're here. My back is killing me. I'm gonna take it. I'm going right to bed. I'm doing no homework. I'm gonna go to school tomorrow pissed. I'm gonna wake up like, and be like, Mr. Malone, you do your homework? I'm gonna be like, of course not. I had a stream. I had 60 people watching me. You're here? Alright, lit. Alright, so basically you have, oh, I like these styles. Very minimalist style, but overall, making things match is a really big key. Was that Malcolm X? Ooh. And like stuff like this matches really well. The text is done really nicely, and I wouldn't make this logo so much a part of this. I would keep this just by itself. It's very nice by itself, for sure. So stuff like that, making these leaves a little bit more poppy rather than like having this kind of place there. A little more explosive like these could have gotten more in my face, would have been a lot better. And maybe making this black bar right here mix a different color, like green, to match these leaves would have done a little bit more rather than this being gray, because it looked a little bit awkward. But stuff like that could have helped. The little dicky header, the X's could have been like a more of like a paint style rather than it being like that. There's fonts on defont.com like True Lies and stuff like that, and they've done a really good job of helping there. Same thing, stop adding the huge stroke on it, maybe a little bit more in your face, maybe like a more of a white color, like True Lies font to help complement that big black X's or whatever you want to use. White X, black. I would go with red, or like purple. But these big strokes and stuff like that, I would just really worry about and like penciling them out correctly. And when you get to like this stuff, maybe this background looks a little bit too plain. Maybe adding like a little bit less of a shadow on these texts to make it more of a flat design would have done a lot better. It just looks a little bit too much, if you understand. So, hope that helped. I hope it was worth the wait. That Batman Forever font on the flare. Ah. Dude, 19 more. Cruise creation. You here? You here? I'm here. I'm dying. The OG fine, dude. Lele, I really like that flare one. I would just worry about that toning down that that drop shadow for sure. No Man's Sky. Yo, anybody play No Man's Sky? I heard that game is actually mad good. But overall, it's a desktop wallpaper. It's very clean for a desktop wallpaper. It's very simplistic. If I was to want a desktop wallpaper for this game, I probably would have choose this one. But the CC is a little bit too much. You guys can see the contrast is a little bit too much in that gradient. But totally. Just worry about stuff like that. At the leaves, something came up. Hoping to be back in time for the end. Hopefully. I'm only going to be doing this for like another hour. But stuff like this, creating that shadow, not copying Allier's logo. Simple stuff like that you have to worry about. Means a lot, dude. You're welcome. I'm just trying to help people out for sure. This is going to be uploaded onto YouTube. So if you want to go back and just rewatch it for yourself, you totally can. Totally can. With your logos, just like making these like the same size. It's like simple stuff like this. Like I've seen logos like this all the time, but like making sure the spacing are evenly done. Making sure that the blocks are the evenly done. But it looks like you're doing a really good job creating that. Maybe this like this part right here looks a little weird, that snowflake. But these pyramids are done really well. Very simplistic and very clean. Company would pick that up. They really needed like a pyramid style for their portfolio for 100%. So Chase, you're up next. A lot of stuff going on, and I'm gonna go through your abstract landscapes and another thing. It looks like a lot of like Limbo games type of stuff, and I would just worry about maybe making this gradient a little bit better and this moon a little bit more up close. This little like lower opacity kind of stuff a little trips me out a little bit. But it's, you know, very clean gradient right here, very simplistic style. The moon is a little bit weird because it has that big shadow, but if you kept that a little more dull, it would look a lot better. And I'm gonna go through this cartoon portraits for a little bit. And your iris and stuff like this, you guys can see like he has iris right here, and it would be the same thing unless you have a lazy eye, which I don't know. It's always in the middle of your eye. And for your hair, hair is always the most important key part of doing a portrait because you need to like understand it. And with your ears, a lot of people don't know about anatomy. I'm going to be doing a very big video on that as well. Anatomy, your ears line up with the top of your ear and the bottom of your mouth. So like your ear starts with your eyes. You can like follow it. It's like starts with your eyes and then it follows to your mouth. So it's just like a big thing to know about. Your nose wouldn't be that big. But once you take a class on it, you'll understand it a lot more. Same thing, your ears would be more up here to drop down. So it's like knowing the anatomy a lot more could have helped a lot better, for sure. So, Real, you're up next. All right, more 3D styles. Same thing I've said before, don't repeat things in your portfolio. Creating the lighting is a little bit more difficult. Making things glow a lot better. Lighting, when I say lighting, I don't mean lighting like this or like lighting like that. I mean like true lighting, like lighting coming from the top, creating shadows under things. But like not just lighting everywhere, like lightning bolts. Like that looks a little bit awkward if you understand what I'm talking about. Aw, dude, just finished and you had to leave. Crap. As I said before, bro, it's beyond to YouTube. Write down the time. 1 hour and 32 minutes. Write that down. Go on the video tomorrow. Go check it out. But this lighting and stuff like this, this looks really nice. Probably the strongest piece. But like stuff like this, you really want to worry about not cluttering everything and making it so like so much stuff. And you're a beginner. I'm not gonna judge you too hard, but I hope you understand what I'm coming from. So, Muna, you are next. Hey Bear, I left 10 minutes ago. What did I miss? I went through about like 10 portfolios. Maybe story time. I don't know. I'm probably told some story. Drinking Dunkin' still. I'm almost finished. It's really gross, but I'm trying. My back hurts. My back really hurts. I'm sitting so weird. My wrist. Where's my wrist? I don't know if you can hear it, dude. It's almost me. God damn. What's a good way to make a Gen Art Sapphire Effects S _ Chroma Rat? Couldn't tell you. Don't even know what that means. Necessarily. So Alonzo, dude, you were here since the beginning for sure. 10 and 10 minutes. I don't think I went through 10 and 10 minutes, probably like 3 or 4 and 10 minutes. But same thing, when you're doing like styles like this, if you're doing a 2 astronaut banners, what is this, Muna, don't add both, add the best one, add your best work. And like stuff like this is very clean, but these lower opacity perks looks a little bit awkward. Maybe adding them right here to fit with this logo and the social links. So stuff like that should work together a lot more rather than stuff like that. And when you get to like thumbnails, of course you're doing the good job of making the text the bigger part of what you want to watch rather than having big things pop up. And making them glow a lot is very good to the naked eye of like something that you want to click on. You can see if I wasn't watch a Fallout chapter 1 of the pandemic game, I would probably click on this because it shows what I want to watch in the chapter 1. It sells me. Like, it's going to be, oh, I want to go click on that and I want to watch. So, Frey Studios or Seamus M, you're next. It's like the RGB split, but a lot more for chroma split. I'm not too familiar with that, so I couldn't really tell you. Really couldn't tell you. Seamus with the beats. When you're doing something like this, I really like the style overall. It's very cartoonish in style, but this right here, how this blurs this, is really agitating to my eyes. I would have had more of like a straight edge down and make this a lot more of a straight edge. This shadow is done really well, and pricing and wireless is done also well, and it's very simplistic and it's very like sell it to your client. Maybe adding a little bit more of a lighting strip or something like this, bringing out a lot more lighting and shadows could have helped, or blending out stuff. But totally. The iconic light behind the source and light up here, I can tell because the quality isn't so up there. And of course, I like how you brand things because a lot of people want to see their work branded if they want something. Once you get into your flat design, I went through you with this with a for my top five, very clean styles and stuff. But I would just worry about not cluttering and not like using weird things. And my nature pack, you guys can go on any like website or something like that and find color palettes. But in my nature pack, I have a really good color palette scheme that you can use, like using maybe a more of a brighter yellow and more complementary colors to the red. Would have worked a lot better. And when you get more towards this, is using that RGB split and like motion blur and magical looks could have been a lot done a little less, just because of stuff like that. So, if you know what I'm talking about. And when you get to the scuff advertisement, it's just matching stuff. You can't have circles along with like, I don't know, like a Victorian style, and like making this like stuff blur. That you thought it would look nice. This looks a little bit awkward to the eye. It kind of irritates me, like the eyes, if you understand where I'm coming from. So Hambone, you're up next. I'm gonna read the chat and like just lay down. I hope I get reviewed, bro. I'm going through every portfolio until I'm done. After I hit like 50, whatever, I'm probably gonna be done. After I hit like 945, the people are still submitting, I'm gonna kind of close the link down and chill. My nose is running. Ugh. So, you know what? Screw the thing I have to deal with. That person can wait 40 minutes. Facts. Dude. Screw college English. Ugh. We read an essay about, like, our beliefs. And I'm reading, like, a belief that success won't chase you. Dude, it's so dumb. It's literally the dumbest thing I've ever done. For Hambone, your portfolio. Hambone, your portfolio. I would make these 3D ones. A really big thing with portfolios, guys, I'm going to make a video, of course, on this as well. I have a lot of videos planned. I'm just kind of lazy. Is making things match each other. Like, have your 3D in a row and then have your 2D. Dicks out for Harambe. But basically, like, stuff like this you have to worry about is just making these things blur a little bit, kind of creating the depth field. I went over a lot in like these top portfolio reviews, and I feel really bad like going through the end ones really fast, but it's the same thing over and over again. As I said, that creating like shadows and like light sources and stuff like that, and you know, stuff like that. But when you get to here, like these paint splatters don't really match anything. The soccer ball could have been a little bit more blurred rather than it making another layer and blurring that. And just like paint splatters everywhere don't really match the whole style. But when you get to like stuff like this, you're doing a good job just kind of creating that very good techie feel. But like I said, totally just put your 3D with 3D and 2D with 2D. Don't clutter it as much as possible and stuff like that. So other graphics, Twitch graphics, same thing. Make these a little bit smaller because you don't want them to take up so much of the screen. And I think you'd be honestly set, bro. Just make sure you have your 3D with 3D and 2D with 2D 100%. Did I do formula yet? I might have. Not too sure. Not too sure. Might have. I think someone could tell me. So, I always ruin my designs because I don't know what to add. Yeah, adding stuff to your designs can kill you sometimes. It's like writing an essay. If you don't know what to write, don't keep writing. Stop, go to the next section that you want to write about and then start there. Same thing with design. If you're drawing something or making something, if you're stuck on something, just like totally scrap it and then go work with something else. So, let me click on this. No, Foreman, we didn't go through your portfolio yet. So it's still lost in the list somewhere. There's only like 10 of them left, so I'm taking my time doing. It's my chair. Oh. Anyone have questions? Anyone ask anything? Someone asked something up there earlier. Something about a font list. One day, can you make a list of the fonts you use? Of course I can, dude. 100%. I would totally do that. Just I need to take time. It takes a lot of time to make videos. Like, I know you guys don't understand that. It takes me like hours to make videos, like 2 hours, 3 hours. It takes like an hour to record, an hour to edit, an hour to like make it look good. But this is Sensor Designs, and as I said before, guys, when you're doing these portfolios and stuff like this, and you guys want to make advertisements, you want to sell the product. You won't want to use a blurry picture. You want to use the most high quality picture. Make sure that this blue matches this blue, and that everything matches together. Of course, don't clutter it so much with text. That's what the brief and that's what the description is for. 100 times better than doing stuff like that. And when you get to like, the YouTube banners, using like Cinema 4D renders, like this kind of stuff, looks a little bit weird. The background's too black, and you need to start kind of like putting more stuff together. And for AVIs, I'm not too much of a fan putting these in portfolios, at least, but like this one's good. Maybe adding a shadow right here and using a better high quality image is very, very useful. And same thing I said, like the background just looks a little bit too weird. And just never put a template in your portfolio. Just fill the name with something, of course, but stuff like that. Never add the AVI render, just like stuff like that. I hope you guys understand, like, never, it's like taking an iPhone and using an iPhone case in a Samsung Galaxy advertisement. It's like not right. Like, don't do that. So, one day can you make the list of fonts I used? Yeah, I'm totally planning on it. Navi. Dude, I'm sweating right now. Now Navi. I'm gonna talk about this actually. I already went through so many 3D things. When you're doing stuff like this and copying like this, make sure that the text matches. Like, I know Google. Let's just go to it real quick. Google has. Are you fucking serious? Google has like a black with like a very nice sleek look to it. Make sure that yours matches good and that the font doesn't have like a shadow onto it. It's a good idea for sure, but make sure like, that shadow isn't there. You know, it matches good. The fonts look very nice together, and very good use of your tools and making this text over again, and making this stuff blend together a little bit better would have worked a lot better. And maybe using a different color CC or a different filter, stuff like that, could have been a lot better. And when you get to your banners, don't overkill it, flipping the same thing over and over again and making it like the same contrast. And when the same thing I went over in my first portfolio I reviewed is making the water a lot different. Like, if you want to put the logo inside the water, make sure the top is a lot lighter than the bottom. It's just how things work out, to be honest. And same thing, guys, don't use your clan templates things to use in here. Just make your own. And you did a good job putting some stuff in front of it, but you can tell that you have like a weird transparency of stuff like this. Like, this should have been in front of the logo maybe, instead of like going right through it. So I hope that is a lot more understandable for you. Like, you need to just take your time and like cut things out and put it together. So call me Koosie Garrett. What up, Koosie? Cussie? Koosie? Cussie? What is it? I know you're in the chat. Cussie? Koosie? Koosie, yeah, I got you. Koosie. How do I add my response? The portfolio. Koo. Oh. Ooh. Ooh. It's like an owl. Nah, dude. Oh, God, I'm typing ats. Kousie? Kousie. Bang this one out, brother. Overall, good style. Like, I went over this. I hope. Kousie or Koosie, yeah, Koosie, I got you. Same thing I went over in the phase jeb one. Making the clouds a lot more displaced could have been a lot better of a job. Making the sizing different. How do I explain this out to you guys in a very fashionable way? My amazing art skills that I'm gonna be drawing for you guys for like the next like 4 years. Gotta get better somehow. If you have, it's about to be a really good picture. If you have a bird, that's a really bad bird. It's a bird, W, right? It's how kids drew when they were kids, a W. You got a flock of birds flying, and you have a balloon, like an air balloon. The air balloon goes like, why is that so weird? What the hell happened there? All right, so you have your air balloon. It's a very large air balloon, but you don't want the, there you go. I don't know what air balloons look like. I just know they look like this. But let's take, you can see that like it's up close and stuff like this. But yours, for some reason in my eye, just looks like, I know it's supposed to be far away, but it looks like it's supposed to be up close. Maybe if you added some things in front of it, like that cloud, it could have done a lot better of a job making that create that big effect. So, 100%. Same thing I've been saying. Try not to swap things like this, like paint splatters and like circular objects. Like, try to keep the same style for the one thing. You did a good job morphing this together, but I don't like how you added the G, the O, the V are both like swapping that rectangle, and then you hit the E and the S and it just stops. Like, you need to be consistent throughout stuff like this, and it really helps overall. But same thing I've been saying here, really good job. Esports community, very clean and very basic, and very clean. I know it's from my tutorial, but of course it's a very clean style. And same thing here, very clean. A very good use of colors and complementary colors for sure. So good job, Koosie. All right, Peaceful, you're next. All right, Peaceful. So I've seen a style like this 100 times. When you're doing styles, never try to match someone. Try to do your own thing. Shadows. I'm gonna say that first. Shadows, you did it here, but not here for some reason. But right here, you did a good job creating that light source coming up. Maybe if you darkened a little bit up here, it looks too much a little saturated. And you're doing a good job. Maybe when you guys do stuff like this, I can't even imagine being this good at GFX. What do you mean? But like stuff like this, if you did a good here with the logo, is making the inside some less transparent. It could have done a lot better here. Maybe that stroke could have been a lot less. But once you get to like here, really good. But like the little opacity stuff that's in the background's a little weird. Maybe the skulls are a little awkward. But maybe blurring a little bit the sides could have like helped bring out your eye to that logo a little more. And you did a good job making this stuff complementary to each other and making stuff work. Maybe taking out that three bars though would have been a little bit better of a job. And when you're doing stuff like this, like the Suicide Squad logo, definitely for sure try to match it the best you can, like rotating them and stuff like that. Like, since I have it open anyway, Suicide Squad text tutorial, there you go, Google. Like you can see, like right here, like they're supposed to be like swapped and switched and stuff like that. Just like something you have to worry about is like trying to match stuff like this. Did a really good job here. This is actually my top 5. Nothing bad to say about that. Perfect job. Very clean job here with the white speckles and stuff like that, and the white text. They very work together. And but once you get down here, you start to like realize like you falling apart with the black lines and everything like that. So of course, just try your best to kind of match everything. And when you get to the advertisements, is this harsh CCs and a lot of contrast and exposure. I would just try to worry about. And like stuff like this is really good. It's a really good style, but of course, like you gotta worry about proportions. Like the tree wouldn't be that big compared to that tube. That's like, I'll put it to scale. I like drawing. I'm very bored. I'm not bored doing this, but like, I want to draw. All right, you got a piece of broccoli, right? You got a. There you go. That's not what anybody. That's not what a tree looks like. Oh, I'll redraw it for you. Yeah, like a tree, some shadows, right? You got the branches coming down. All right, now you got a big tree. All right, you got the ground. So let's say a tree is here, give or take, that's probably like the size of a house. So then you got like a big house, maybe like a barn. Yeah, but you got a big barn, right? So basically, you have this. The tree is the proportion of this. The tube would not be that big. The tube would be huge. So like, you gotta worry about proportions and stuff like that. It's a very good concept, but proportions are key to everything. Like right here, a pineapple would be a lot bigger than the tube, but the pineapple slices might match the same size of the tube. Stuff like that. Rendering this out a lot more, adding materials. Did a really good job here selling the product. And so like I said, very good job. You know, you want to sell a product, you want to get your stuff done to get better. So hope you guys like my drawings, dude. 13 more. Crescent, you're up next. Yeah, it makes even more sense. What are you guys talking about? I haven't done formula prior. All right. Oh, what was the weird port? Tumblr? I can't use Tumblr. Don't sell your templates on your portfolio. Same thing, guys. You gotta worry about placing stuff. And I don't want to keep going through this kind of stuff, but you gotta keep worrying about placing stuff. Making sure that text matches all of each other, lighting, logos don't match things, sell things, stuff like that. For portfolio reasons, thumbnails, always try to make the text as big as possible, and of course, don't overkill things. Who's texting me? Bitches. But like I said, you gotta worry about text placement and everything like that, for sure. Tumblr, though, weird choice for a portfolio, man. Weird choice for a portfolio. Formula, are you ready? Are you ready? I'm gonna sit in the chat until you speak. That was gross. I'm gonna stand up, bro. I gotta fix my shorts. Oh. Didn't know you lived near Albany. I live in Maine. And well, which is like 2 hours from there. Dude, Maine is not 2 hours from Albany. Actually, no. Maine is probably like, should I send out a joke if you want to? Maine is like a 5 hour drive from my house, like an hour and a half to Albany. No, it's like 45 to Albany, so it's like 4 hours to Albany, or 4 hours to Maine. Depending on where you're going in Maine, don't get me wrong, but like, to get on like the Mass Turnpike, he left. Pissed. Alright. Basically, it's getting ready to his portfolio and bang it out. Advertisements like this, you don't want to just crack down and everything like that. Oh, my town is called Maine. Oh, I didn't know that. But like, stuff like this, like advertisements, don't use the same bottle and flip it around 100 times. And don't add text like this if you're not going to be consistent with adding text. Same thing here, very clean and very good style of a record. Records are very old, but it's very good. Next, my four-legged just won my second account. All right, I see. There's like stuff like that, dude. It's very good style, but you want to worry about if you're gonna make a CD, that wouldn't match as well as using a record, if you understand what I'm talking from. The logo, the brightness is just a little bit too much. The text a little bit weird. No, blending things together is a very good key. Maybe adding more shadows onto this and making that astronaut a little less transparent. And shadows, man, shadows, lighting would be shooting here, creating a shadow on the text. This kiwi idea is very good, maybe making this less of a watermelon and more of a kiwi would have been a lot better. And like, when you get to the nade shot stuff, making that text a little bit bigger. I understand who it is, but that's because I'm a nerd and I watch this stuff. But like, I hope you understand, like, if you're gonna keep that flat design style, don't add little like blood splatters. Like, you gotta worry about stuff like that. And same thing with banners. Don't repeat things in your portfolio. If you think the banner looks better than the header, only put the banner in. If the header looks better than the banner, or vice versa, just only put one section of it in. So definitely just work on your lighting, man. Lighting and shadows, making the text a little bit bigger. Just like stuff like that, you have to worry about. It's very key. All right, who's this next? Rapid, and I'm gonna go through. I've been going through social media a lot, so I'm gonna go through some client logos and very clean F Fox style. Maybe making these edges a little bit more crisp could have helped a lot better. Maybe you did this in Photoshop or something, but like making the edges a little bit more crisp could have helped. And this idea is really secure for the IHOP. It looks like a hop-in logo for Phase Hop-In. But you understand what I'm talking about. Maybe taking this out. I'm not too much of a fan of this than I am this. So, and when you get the illustrations, very up close and personal, but I would just try to back this up a little bit and look at the whole entire thing. So, stuff like that. I don't know what a forum signature is, and I'm just gonna stay away from social media until I hit like one that I only have to. RJ, work from last year. League of Legends, I don't play computer games. Yeah, client concept. Very good concept. Maybe that little play button's a little bit too big, but the name and level looks pretty nice. It's very clean. Looks like a very old style. And same thing as I said before. You want to sell the product, and you're doing a really good job here with the shoe advertisements and with selling the product. But for the Steph Curry thing, this very grungy background doesn't really match too much well with everything else like that. So I hope you understand that a lot more. So for Kitty or Gimbala. Old. When are you looking? 2014. Just like lighting, and obviously it's 2014 styles, but just like try to be less abstract and getting a lot more clean. For 2014 old, I really don't know what to say. Very old styles, but this was the style back then, so I can't really say anything about it. The portfolio set up a little awkwardly, but these little white borders on the side of things just don't really end up well looking clean, so just like things you have to worry about. So Daniel Graphics, you're up next, brother. And overall, very good, like very good styles right here, guys. That's what I'm talking about. Maybe making this a little bit brighter and maybe adding like a brush onto here, but very clean, making sure things end up in where they're supposed to be. Very, very nice, you know, making colors flow together. And same thing here, you did a good job making everything work together. That font choice, of course, is a little bit weird, and how you added these little I think the St. Rose logos or whatever. I don't know what the hell that game's called anymore. But the text looks a little bit weird, and the Mario is a tutorial. Still, I mean, adding tutorials in your portfolio is not the best idea, but it's done very nicely. So he probably learned something from doing it. And just adding shadows, guys. You have to add shadows. And this Cloud Nine banner is very, very clean. I would have kept the whole entire thing blue. And same thing, shadows. You know. A little bit brighter, and it's a very clean style, and you can see that he's using the same CC from this that he did the Mario banner, so it's just something you have to worry about, and keeping the same styles with the same styles, if you understand what I'm saying, brother. Just want to keep the same stuff, and I'm not going to try to skip through everyone's like portfolio, but I'm trying to get through them fast so I can get through everyone, have a little neat conversation with people, and then get on my way typing essays. So for the Siberian headset, I've seen a lot of logos and a lot of things, so you have time to drop in 100%. But just making the text a lot more to see and trying to sell that product a lot better. It's not very convincing that you want to buy this product when all you see is half the text. So something you want to worry about. Right here is a very nice style. I'm not too sure if you made both of them, but like this is very clean. I like the contrast to it and how it's more of a Western feel. So you have to sell the products with advertisements and stuff like that. So it's just something you have to worry about. And for the esports community is maybe making this a little bit less opacity, a little less like bright, and making these logos a little more less awkward and repeating things like that. The strokes are never too good to do and just everything like that. Same thing here, maybe making these people more so of the banner rather than having the text so much, and maybe making the text match things a lot better. Creating colors rather than keeping this like a gray tint to this black, and making things pop. So, but Kenny, sorry, my phone's going off a lot. I have to go pick up some clothes at an ex-girlfriend's house. It's really annoying. Just like stuff like this, man. Like you did a good job, but like maybe making this text in the middle a little bit more. Maybe this little like shadows around the Envy logo is a little bit weird. But everything else looks really good. The blurriness is a little bit too much for my personal taste, but you have to like work with what you got. So Staffy, this is next. Dude, I'm gonna throw this Dunkin' Donuts up. Revamps. All right. Probably something I've never said before. Making things a little bit darker could have helped a lot better. Maybe creating that more dirty. A little more of a dirty feel, like a little dark feel to it, or just like lighting here, blending things together, creating that little effect. Duplicating text sometimes never works the best. Said before, guys, make sure these things have worked together. This looks very well together, but maybe making this like explosion, like glow the guy, the ice wouldn't be splashing here, the water isn't like shaking that much, just like stuff like that you have to understand. Especially when you get to like here is making the guy pop out a certain way rather than like having certain arms come out and having like renders and stuff go through it rather than having like a little circle where it would be entering. And just like stuff like that you have to really put into consideration when you're doing this project like this. So you have to understand that you take a concept of like, back to the pictures, make a new layer. You have a circle and you can either have a ring that goes up and around it like Saturn, or you can have something that goes behind it that like you don't understand that it's a ring but it goes like behind it like this, right? So you can have a ring that goes behind it that's floating behind it, or it goes in front of it. And you can never have like something like this that goes like this. Like, you have to understand that you want to like flow it through the whole entire thing. So like, a very good example is Saturn. You don't want the ring to just stop because it looks a little weird. You want it to flow through, and you want to create it. If you have like a circle and you have a guy poking out of it, you have the head pop up, you know, the legs coming out of it, and he has his arm reaching out but his other arm in. Like stuff like that, you have to understand that you want him to kind of like be protruding out of it in the very good way. So I hope that helps, Staffies, like organizing your stuff and stuff. So Zenity, you're next. Yeah, I said it right. You got a Wix website. Okay, I got music playing. Is that it? Design, social media, identity. I'm going to identity. Is there anything you want me to specifically go through? For identity, of course, maybe making these a little bit, a little like flatter would have worked a lot better. It's very large, but stuff like this reminds me of Crooks and Castles, and it's very good identities for clothing lines. So you might have a good idea of making stuff for the identities for clothing lines. And of course, this is done very, very nicely. But definitely keep this kind of style in the back pocket. Very good for clothing lines. Very, very good. For social media, of course, is blending stuff together. Making this like a lot more better. And when you import pictures onto Wix, make sure you change the name. Like I can see you guys name your files. But it's like stuff like you have to like blend the text a lot better and make it less seem that's more together in the image rather than just placed there. Like right here, this is very a part of the image. So you did a really good job putting that there. Sheesh. Anything else? Maybe advertisements. Same thing as I always said before. You want to sell the product. You're selling the product right here. Maybe create a shadow or something like that. And making these texts, make sure they're spaced evenly and they're centered in the same spot. Making sure that this guy is a highlight of this advertisement with the Achieve Greatness somewhere else to help bring your eye towards him a lot more. So, Hi DVampies has this port sent in, and basically social media and advertisements. And for social media, when you get to stuff like this, you really want to like make sure that you understand what you're trying to show the person. It's very clean and creative, or very abstract and like bright and clean, creative-ish. But like stuff like this is a little bit too much to the naked eye. Like stuff like this, it's gonna be very clean. You know what you're getting, but text is just a little bit awkward. You don't want to work with it in that sort of way. And when you get to advertisements, as I always said, guys, you want to sell the product, and you're doing a really good job making the product feel like something like you want to buy. Sometimes making a very dark and grungy effect to this could do really well, but I would always keep the advertisements as clean as possible because that's the most important. So, Anthony, with your chill productions, oh no, the carbon made doesn't work. If you're interested in your portfolios, please make sure the links work. This is with MGKOGFX, and when you're doing stuff like this, bro, make sure that you're gonna be making everything blend together more, and everything like that, like having the text work, and you know, make sure everything blends together. You know, the earth wouldn't look like this, and the scan lines and the text stocks would go in front of it, and you know, these lights wouldn't be so abrupt, and they would just be a lot more clean. But as I said before, when you're doing advertisements, or not advertisements, excuse me, thumbnails, make the text a lot bigger and have like the background image and stuff like that. So it's always stuff I've been saying. Make sure that everything matches. You don't want to have a big gradient on text when the other one doesn't. So it's just like something that you guys want to have to like look out for, stuff like that. So I hope you're understanding what I'm saying. Jack, you're up next, getting down close to the end. What up, Anthony? What up, Tiger? What's going on? Advertisements for you. Same thing, sell a product. Maybe making this a lot more clean and maybe not taking out these things. These paint splatters don't really match the geometric of these lines, kind of like the things you want to fill up. It's a very good shoe advertisement. I would make the city a lot more clean. But it's a very good idea. You know, the text doesn't really match too well, but the whole entire thing itself looks really good together. Very clean portfolio. Same thing with social media. You don't want to just have this block placed here with like leaves, geometric shapes, and then have plants come out of it. Like, you got to understand you want things to match. And a very clean style right here is adding your name right here to the red part of the Canon lens. And just like stuff like this, you're doing a very good job being clean with, and you're very understanding the geometric shapes have to match geometric. Of course, I'm gonna go back to this for an example. You don't want geometric to be with a very abstract and very plant like. So I hope that works. What was this? Wallpapers? Basically same thing I've been saying. Doing a really good job making everything together. So I'm getting real tired right now. This is the last one. Link up, baby. Alright. Ooh, 3D. Really good styles. This is exactly what I'm talking about. It's a very good example for the people that are watching still, the 35 or 40 people. Is creating those shadows under the text to make sure everything matches. And the lighting source is very everywhere in this, but he understands that the shadows are being casted through some stuff. Not so much right here, but, you know, through everything else he is. Like, you know, the shadows are going to be inside of here. The shadows will be under, shadows will be around. And for the 2K16 stuff, the lighting will create the shadows and the lighting and stuff like that. Lighting will become here, shadows will be casted. So you guys really need to be brought into the idea of where the shadows and lighting will be coming from. You know, this lightning is going to create very clean lights through here. Maybe make a little, like, spark and stuff like that. And then, of course, the shadows will be where the light isn't hitting. Same thing, this arrow logo will be covering a lot of the light hitting the side of the logo, and it's just like the same thing over and over again. That I want you guys to understand that if you have a big light source going around, it's gonna light up everything that's around it. Same thing here, if you're gonna have a bunch of flares going around, it's gonna light up everything else. So that's basically it, guys, and I guess that's it for portfolio reviews. Anybody have any last questions before I head off to bed? Because I'm getting tired. I got stuff to do though. This kind of sucks. Anybody got any questions for now? Have a little question and answer before go sleep, go do some homework. Anybody finish mine? Number 49. Let me see. Oh, I don't want to open it back up. Nice one to finish on, dude. Versus 100%. I need help. The 3D function in Photoshop CC is gone, but I don't know how I can activate it again. It depends. It depends what update you have. If you update to CC, it should have it there. If you downgrade to CS6, it shouldn't be there. If you pay for it, it should be there. Anything like that. What 1+1? 1, 2, 3, 4. A couple more things. I don't want to go through any more like portfolios like that right now. I'm just gonna talk. Let me drink the last like sip of my thing. Yeah, you can just hit me up on Twitter all you want. I'll be on Twitter, guys, all night, so just message me there. I went to until you're going to host a recruitment challenge. Not too sure. Hit up Hi Lycos, or just message me on Twitter in my DMs, and I'll just set you up with the things. And so, everything like that. It's done very well. What do you link me Sapphire for, dude? I don't know. I don't know what they are. If you know what they are, just message me on Twitter, man. I'll slide you the DMs for Lyco or something like that. Do I know what it is? I'm gonna get like. Do I know what this effect? I'm gonna get hit off. I guess that's it for me. It's like 10 o'clock. Gonna end the video.